Thanks for joining us again for the retail and e-commerce panel. We've got three panelists here. We're going to try to do this in 18 minutes.
Very good.
All right. So we'll start over there. We'll introduce yourself and head over there.
I'm Brian Colon. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Virtual APT. And we invent technology for AR and VR. Retail is one of the three major sectors that we focus on to try to take the in-store shopping experience and bring it to the home, because there's this middle ground between the online shopping where you can search yourself and between the going to the stores. There's this wanting to have the shopping experience or wanting to learn more about products without having to search it and being able to get this intimate experience, and to have the augmented reality within the videos to be able to learn more, purchase, whatever to do to add a really cool experience to a shopping experience. And we focus more on that at-home retail for AR rather than the in-store physical AR, just because while the displays can be great, once you're in the store, you're already there to buy the product. We're trying to give it a much wider range of potential customers and to allow companies to grow internationally and monetize with both VR and AR.
Great. I'm Mike Festa. I'm the director of Wayfair Next. At Wayfair, we're an online destination for all things home. Our team basically specializes in developing cutting-edge technology using AR and VR for aiding the customer in visualizing our products. We sell a lot of, you know, large items like couches, for example, through the internet, which is non-traditional. So we're trying to improve that customer experience. You can actually see what the couch is going to look like in your own space and actually make it better than going to the store where, you know, you may look at a large ceiling and see like a big couch and think it's small because it's in a big room, but then when you get it home, it's too big. So if you can actually see that product in your home, we think that that enhances the experience.
Jonathan Agus, so 6 years ago, started a company called Premier Tourist and Landmark Association as a sister company to a pretty significant real estate holdings company based out of Manhattan called Ashkenazi Acquisitions. We own properties such as Union Station in Washington, D.C. We own Faneuil Hall Marketplace right here in your backyard in Boston. We probably, between five properties alone, have over 150 million people that walk through our property. So Patala was created for the purposes of monetizing the common area. So I control all the billboards, for example, and, you know, do a pretty significant sized business working with brands that just want to kind of dominate stations or take over, you know, properties and brand themselves through billboards. I also handle all of the experiential, so brands, again, that want to come to our properties and introduce new brands to consumers. And do product launches, et cetera, and have some heavy, you know, kind of experiences direct to consumers. We handle that as well. Past 2 years, we've kind of entered into the festival business. We're producing now down in Florida in a property that we control in Miami, the largest Hispanic family-friendly festival on April 2nd. And in addition, this past year, we've been heavily touching and interfacing with potential opportunities within the AR space specifically. We're not really focused on VR at all, but rather AR. And, you know, we feel between our properties plus relationships that we have in the tourism business, both domestically as well as internationally, we probably touch 100% of every tourist that enters into the United States, whether it's in through Washington, D.C., Manhattan, California, Miami, et cetera. And, you know, we're going to talk a little bit about some of the ideas that we have, how we can touch directly to consumers, and some of the applications that we, you know, have been thinking about rolling out within the, you know, in the AR space.
All right, keeping with the audience participation theme here. So who's been at the mall lately? A couple of hands, all right. Who's bought something online lately? A lot of hands.
Everybody.
All right. And who's returned something that they bought online lately? All right. And obviously, if you can return something, if you bought something in the mall, you can return something in the mall. So we've got some kind of dynamics there. We've got a push-pull. I mean, obviously, we all understand that Amazon Prime is And all these on-demand services are really changing the consumer's behavior. They're changing the retail environment. How is AR going to keep moving that or affect that?
Well, I mean, I think clearly the trend's showing that that's just going to continue to grow. I don't really see that taking, you know, less of a space. I think, you know, what Wayfair is doing, what Amazon's doing, these big companies that are getting into tech and leaning toward the heavy tech is only bringing more sales to them. We are certainly a big believer in it. And I think that however they want to adopt it to bring a new experience can only help. I think people like the cool, they like the new, they like a customized experience to help their branding, whether or not it adds to sales or not, and to bring from people's home with whatever devices they're on a new experience to lead them to this company, to lead them to this potential sale. I think that's really what the trends are entirely. Is heavily in the online space, purchasing across the world, really.
So just to kind of add a little bit to that, so, you know, again, I see it from a retail consumer perspective. Obviously, I work now with a lot of the, you know, kind of online Amazons, et cetera, of the world. You're not there yet, but that are kind of leaning now towards brick and mortar. You know, Amazon has, you know, launched, and everyone has probably seen pictures of their bookstore that they actually have physical brick and mortar. And a lot of the online concepts are kind of going in that direction. What I want to just kind of deviate for that for a second, if you allow me, because I want to just kind of talk for a second and show a quick video of what we're doing to what I would say take augmented kind of experiences and kind of taking a little bit of an attitude of what a consumer is, how a consumer is going to interact and understand AR, and how we're going to allow people to actually interact with AR, but yet feel that they're walking into a brick and mortar kind of store environment. Because I think, again, you know, you have to have a reason for people to want to use AR today at the consumer level. And I think that we've kind of thought about some concepts that are, you know, kind of interesting. This is a quick video here with a brand called Yokai. It's a Japanese brand that launched, you know, many years ago in Japan, the hottest thing, bigger than Pokemon as far as sales over in Japan. Came over to America, did some licensing deals with lots of different product lines, and we were kind of talking to them about potentially doing an AR concept, but yet popping open a brick and mortar type of an environment that people can come and actually purchase product, and then expand that into an AR experience within, you know, at this Union Station. So just kind of take a look at, you know, how this kind of blends together. And this is the short version of, you know, kind of right to the point. This is the food hall in Union Station. But that's kind of a pop-up experience, which would, you know, potentially have product from all the different verticals and all the license deals that they have, whether it's, you know, with toys and et cetera. And then, you know, you kind of see there the head, you know, this was based on a headset kind of, you know, not necessarily with your phone. And obviously we have a long way to go before we can start renting those things out for the consumers to use. But this is just kind of one example. I spoke to Mall of the Americas, I spoke to Simon, obviously controls some of the biggest malls in the country. You know, they're tired of every kiosk and cart in their mall being the same cosmetic company or the same sneaker company or the same hat company. They're looking for something innovative, they're looking for something new. And they, you know, basically if I pulled the trigger, I could be in every mall of significant, you know, with significant traffic around the United States tomorrow morning if I pulled the trigger. Again, what I'm missing potentially are, you know, is real content, and the devices weren't ready yet for the wearables, so kind of flipping that around into, you know, more of the handheld device. And actually one of my partners is here, we're building out a game, some sort of a gamification to be able to have, and that's John over there in the audience, to really gamify the experience, which is very important. We feel gaming, education, and some sort of, in the future, augmented commerce, I call it, where you could walk by Starbucks and actually put the cup in your, you know, in your pocket, and then, you know, today they have the app that you could pre-order and it's ready, but actually physically walk in the common area of a mall and you just kind of take products, and then it'll be waiting for you at the concierge as you leave, you know, the mall environment. Because we like blending physical, there's a physical component. We believe very much, just like Amazon believed in the web, they now are going into physical. So we believe that the experience has to integrate a physical component, an augmented component, and put it all together.
Are we talking about a mixed reality shopping experience here?
Yes, in all senses, yes.
Yeah, I'm a proponent of that, and I think it's really an exciting possibility. I don't know if Wayfair's going to do that or not. I've been pushing for it, but we'll see. But I think there's a lot of opportunity to kind of take that like mixed experience where, you know, for Wayfair, for example, we sell 7 million products. We can't have a showroom that is that big. However, we could have a small showroom that would be, you know, augmented to give the customer that kind of experience within a smaller footprint that continues to give us that operational, you know, I guess small scale that, you know, to compete with other larger furniture traditional retailers that have huge showrooms that, you know, it's a maze to go through, you know, some of these larger ones. We could kind of reduce some of that fatigue and make it more of a fun experience. Again, I can't say that we're going to do that. It's something I want to do, but who knows what will happen in the future.
We also, and if you could just turn on the slide, we had produced something for Meta. Again, going down that wearable, last year I met with Meta. We were talking much more, and this was really my son's, you know, kind of idea was, you know, how do we do something educational? Union Station, good example, Faneuil Hall. Every eighth grader in America goes through Union Station. There isn't a trip that doesn't go to Washington, D.C. and stop by, and I know that because I sell them food vouchers, et cetera. So we were thinking, we were thinking about how do we educate students that come through Union Station? How do we pop open an experience with content, whether it's through NASA, Lockheed, again, STEM, whatever it may be, but consumer-friendly, educational for the eighth grader, the ninth grader, the seventh grader, that people would actually be informed, and we would, you know, bring in sponsors that would supply the content, et cetera. So we developed, you know, kind of a very simple video that we had shown to Meta last year. And again, we're not ready yet for delivery, so we can't really execute on it yet. Again, it's a pop-up experience. It's like a museum pop-up you would have in the center of a Union Station or a Faneuil Hall. This is just a concept of a timeline of using, you know, kind of augmented reality to, again, sit looking at beautiful Union Station, but yet experiencing some sort of immersive experience, utilizing the, you know, the unbelievable Meta headsets. So that was just a little bit of a, you know, kind of a teaser. Again, the video is much longer than that, but give you some example. And we actually did roll out a small little test. This was a private party that we did at Union Station. That we actually introduced augmented reality. Again, we handed out physical pieces of paper with kind of technology, kind of just, you know, mark it on that piece of paper. And we also had tablets set around to introduce. This was back in October. Main Hall of Union Station was reintroduced to the market after earthquake damage that had been done. So simple, we partnered up with a company out of Finland on the technology side. But we shared history of Union Station through an augmented experience.
I think having experiences like this is really important for educating the public. That's one of our jobs, I think, as early innovators in this space, is to raise awareness around what AR and VR are. Pokemon Go is obviously a huge success, and, you know, as like technologists, we kind of, you know, look at that and say, like, well, that's not really AR. Maybe it is, maybe it isn't. For the consumer, that's what it is. That's what AR is today, because that's what they've seen and that's what they've been told AR is all about. So I think it's up to us to get out there in the community and have experiences like this where people can see what the potential is and say, oh wow, this is much more than what I thought it is. I'm really excited about the future. And it'll give more confidence, I think, for app producers. We're in this, you know, chicken and egg scenario right now where people are excited about the technology, but yet the you know, companies are reluctant to invest like the resources and the time to create content when there's so few people that actually have the product, and yet the consumer has no reason to buy a new product if there's no application. So I think getting that education out there and getting people excited about the product is a good step for us to be doing.
So I'm hearing the word experience a lot here. Does anyone remember the term retail therapy? Does anyone ever use that term? Well, AR is going to help with that, I hope.
It could.
It's going to teach us about educational issues.
So, I mean, my perspective again for the consumer, I'm not focused at all on being only educational. I think educational is great, but it's also potentially boring. So, you know, our goal is to execute on initiatives that are going to be high adrenaline, that are going to be extremely interactive, have an educational component because, you know, for the most part, our venues have a lot of history to them and education is important. But we believe that the adoption is really going to be through the children, the families that want to go on an augmented experience type of tour, again, whether it's Pokemon style through a device or whether it's a wearable in the future. But it's got to be, you know, heavy on the content. The IP's got to be substantial. It's got to be recognizable. It's got to be exciting. And I always describe it as when you're driving down Fifth Avenue and you're in a double-decker bus and you're taking that boring tour and you're stuck at the traffic light on 45th Street and Fifth Avenue, or wherever you are, and you want to look at the Empire State Building, you want to see King Kong swinging, you know, from the Empire State Building as you're learning when it was built and who the architect was and all the other, and, you know, incredible features. And at the same time, you want to buy your Broadway ticket. You want to see a little teaser on, you know, going on that you can see what's going on. You can see what's for dinner tonight and have the ability to do, again, the commerce component. Don't know how, you know, fast we can get that done. I'm not on the coding side. I'm not on the technology side per se. And definitely I feel that we're going to hopefully in the near future get into the commerce side.
So what I would say is, you know, for the AR to be adoptive, you know, and spread quickly, it needs to be value added to companies. They're not just going to burn money as marketing expense because it's unproven. So you're going to have two companies. You're going to have two sets, really. You're going to have ones that are early adopters that are willing to take a chance, that are willing to go for something, and you have ones that are waiting to see something being proven and waiting to see, you know, years of analytics to make sure that it's worthwhile for their brand and what message it's sending and all that stuff. And you have companies like Wayfair is doing it now, right? But it's also fitting into their model that they need to do it. They have 7 million SKUs. That's crazy, right? Big size items, I don't know how many tens of thousands of square feet of space you would need to show all of it, but if you want to get into a Manhattan, you can't show every product. I mean, you're just spending way too much money. So either you're going to show it on the technology, or you're going to cut the SKUs down, and if they have a demand for these products and they're selling it with good margins and they can drive sales in another way through AR and they can show it how useful it is in your home, in the space that you need it, there's value added to having this technology, and it's a tiny price to pay, whatever their internal and external technology costs are, whatever their salary component is, the profits that they make by all these extra SKUs that they're not able to have as their top sellers in a store, that they're not able to sell where they don't have stores. I think it's, to me, it seems like a no-brainer for a lot of companies out there that they should be really jumping into it. And a lot of companies have a lot of reasons why they should be slow to adopt, because there's not an obvious way to monetize right now. And maybe it is just a branding expense for now.
Great. So we are going to wrap up here. I think the battle continues online, bricks and mortar, experience.
Hybrids, yeah, exactly.
Hybrids. Stay tuned. Thank you. And appreciate it.
Great.
Thank you.